monsters. I was an angel. Alright, welcome everybody back to my channel. I've got the next article for you here that I've posted on my site. This, like I said, I've been doing a video for each blog post. Some people don't like to read, so I kind of just summarize them real quick. They're not long articles, but I think I've got like 11 or 12 up there, and we're just going through them all, and I'm putting out videos each day, and, you know, I'll try to continue writing more and more and more if because there's definitely more relevant points, I'm sure, that I'll think, hey, that would be a good, you know, topic to talk about. So, that's it. I hope everybody's doing well. You see, I have a Christmas tree behind me here. Like I said in one of my other videos, I like the holidays, and I think it's fun. And, you know, even though, well, I kind of live by myself, but Christmas with the gins this year. Soon there'll be presents under there. I got them stuffed animals and stuff, so I'll have Christmas with them, and it'll be fantastic. And we'll play Christmas music. I'll have a Christmas cookie party, and it'll be dandy. But I'm going to go over this article called Stealth Bioterrorism and Biological Sabotage, the Means and Methods of Clandestine Germ Warfare. And of course, it is relevant to my recently published book, The Sleeper Agent, The Rise of Lyme Disease, Chronic Illness, and the Great Imitator, Antigens of Biological Warfare. And a lot of these articles are going over aspects that is kind of crucial to understanding and further clarification. So if you've read the book, it offers further clarification. If you haven't read the book, it offers some insight before you read the book, and you'll understand it even better. So this is about how biological warfare was the favored warfare, unbeknownst to most people who think that, oh, it's like the Cold War was about, you know, nuclear weapons. That's actually not true. Nobody was dumb enough to use nuclear weapons, knowing how much destruction it would cause, you know, and especially with the whole mutually assured destruction. Like, if you hit us, we're gonna hit you, and it's got that, you know, it's just complete devastation. There's no surviving it. And you know, leaders like, you know, Stalin and such, they like their power. They don't want to compromise their power. They love power. Leaders love power, and they know that nuclear weapons takes that power away. So, what's left is chemical and biological weapons. And the thing about chemical weapons is that you can't get away with using chemical weapons and saying, hey, that was an act of nature. You know, Mother Nature just decided to drop a whole bunch of sarin gas on you guys. You can't get away with it. But that's why biological warfare was the go-to, because you could get away with saying oh, it was an act of nature. You know, you devastate a country with nasty diseases and say, hey, it was an act of nature, global warming, you know, and things like that. And so that's why biological warfare became such a favored warfare. And the reason why you don't hear about it is because a lot of this stuff is seriously, like, classified. You know, like a third of modern history is classified. And that's, you know, something that John Loftus points out in the introduction to my book, is that, you know, nobody really hears about these activities because it's all classified. And so I just happen, because, see, the thing is that when you're passionate about something, right, you work to find the truth about that. And, or, you know, like for me, it was, I wanted to figure this story out. A lot of it was classified, but there's so much of it that you can verify in other ways, especially since they all those scientists love to publish their work. They can't resist. And so, you know, kind of like they like to brag about what they do, and there are ways to finding things out when you're passionate about, you know. And I learned immunology. I learned Traub's immunology, and just, well, immunology in general, but knowing his was a serious advantage. And learning, studying all of his published work, it gave me a superior understanding that is even better than most doctors, because they aren't even trained about this stuff. And they're not passionate about learning it. They just want a paycheck, you know? But when you're actually passionate about learning it, you don't need school. You don't need anybody to show you. You can find out yourself. You can teach yourself things, and that's what I love to do. Anyway, very few are aware of just how much activity was going on in the Cold War with biological warfare. Well, actually, going back to 1918. And in 1938, Stalin declared it was the weapon to fight future wars. He had this memo that was circulating, you know, around his generals. And they talked about how this is going to be the weapon to fight future wars. And like I said, they liked it because they could blame it on nature. And then if they could blame it on nature, that means they could attack as much as they wanted with less fear of retaliation. And the way this is done usually is through sabotage. So what happens is it's fought through intelligence channels. So you got these, you know, spies and such that are in the enemy country that another country, say, wants to attack. They activate those spies. Like, you'll have people who work in agriculture, you'll have people who work, you know, in big pharma, you'll have people who work in biodefense activities, and the enemy activates those people, and they carry out secret acts of sabotage. And that's what happened in the Cold War, like right after World War II, all the way up into the 50s. And it continued, you know, well after Eric Traub was sent back to Germany with other people. And they got, based on, you know, in the last chapter, it looks like they basically flooded our public health system with dubious people, and then they're the ones directing public health policy. So, do the math. But it was always fought through sabotage and things of that nature, through intelligence channels. Saboteurs that would be, you know, implanted into the system or the country that they want to attack. And there was a really good book by this ex-KGB guy, Alexander Kuzminov. And he wrote a memoir called Biological Espionage, Special Operations of the Soviet and Russian Foreign Intelligence Services in the West. And he was talking about all the plans that they had for, like, large-scale bioterrorism against Western civilians, you know, going back to the Cold War, like, early days of the Cold War. And he talked about this Day X. And there's a chapter in my book. And I've talked about this in articles before, like when I used to write on the Garden of Great Work site. But I'll read the quote here from him, and he's talking about these terrifying plans for attacking civilians in the West with bioterrorism. He says, because he worked in a Section K or Department 12 of the KGB, and he says this. He says, but as for us in Department 12 officially, we assisted the government in carrying out the state agricultural and medical programs by obtaining from overseas new fertilizers, modern medicines, and biological products for medical, pharmacological, and microbiological industries of the country. But in fact, we were supposed to obtain from the West the intelligent information which would help to produce and perfect Soviet and later Russian biological weapons in as many possible varieties. The list of the espionage targets included Western governments, government departments, and state commissions, intelligence services, ministries of defense, agriculture, health, environment, civil defense and emergency, secret military, medical, and biological laboratories. In fact, anything connected with the research in the field of genetic engineering and the most dangerous human and animal pathogens. The department gathered intelligence information about plans for and means of protection against the potential application of biological weapons in target countries. Apart from that, we were also interested in which academic and at first glance unthreatening conventional research experiments with recombinant molecules and biological toxins could be applied to create new types of biological and toxic weapons. Our department was also interested in which laboratories, institutes, centers, and private biotechnological companies were secretly involved in programs to protect against bacteriological and toxin weapons. We had to investigate any possible security weaknesses associated with those organizations and penetrate them. The other task of our department was to obtain new strains of modified pathogenic agents, samples of other novel biological materials from the West secret military medical laboratories, and secretly deliver them to Russian clandestine laboratories, which developed and perfected their own offensive biological weapons. People were another of Department 12's prime interests, professionals in biological and medical fields, especially those who were involved in experiments with recombinant molecules, toxins, and pathogens of dangerous human and animal diseases, which could be used for the development of a new generation of biological and toxin weapons. We are also interested in government and army personnel and officials of intelligence services who had direct or indirect access to enemy biological weapons programs, as well as those who provided security for biological weapons laboratories and centers. Our goal was to recruit some of these people as special agents. We also recruited foreigners who could be used by the department as auxiliary agents. For example, those who could help to document and support the cover stories of our illegals and help with liaising them. In the memorandum, one continually met the phrases, the instance, day X, and direct actions. by the instance was meant the Politburo of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union. After disintegration of the Soviet Union, the instance came to mean the President of Russia and his Presidential Council. The formula Day X meant the beginning of a large-scale war against the West. Direct actions implied acts of biological sabotage and terrorism against the civilians, the army, and the economy of a potential enemy. The potential strike targets meant civil targets, including public drinking water supplies, food stores, and processing plants, water purification systems, vaccine, drug, and toxin repositories, and pharmaceutical and biotechnological plants. That's the end of the quote. But, you know, that's a good kind of crystallization of how this war is waged, exactly like that, all of those factors. So, you know, in universities and the academic fields and the public health system officials and biodefense, all a major target. And based on the research that I've been doing for so many years, it looks like we've been completely infiltrated. And if you read the last chapter of my book, it really spells it out for you. Very concerning. And, you know, I know that it's not, like, fun to learn some of this stuff, but the more people know about this stuff, the less that it can hide and maintain itself. Because if more people knew about it, if everybody knew about it, it would not be able to hide. It would not be able to continue. And that's the purpose of writing this book, is to show people this is a brutal form of warfare that needs to stop. And, you know, civilians are the ones who suffer. But that's pretty much it. This is a war of sabotage, and intelligence channels are the ones who fight it. So it's not the people today often have an erroneous idea of what biological warfare actually is. My research really lays it out in this book very well. Most books about biological warfare just talk about, like, the military programs, but they really don't get into the intelligence aspects of it, and you're not going to find a book like this, I guarantee it. Not, I mean, as of right now anyway, this book stands on its own. It is just an in-depth on the esoteric art of stealth biological weapons. So head on over to sleeperagent.com and pick yourself up a copy. Or you go to Amazon. I know Amazon offers free shipping, so that will be out next Wednesday, December 13th. So I'm going to leave it there. And with that said, everybody take care of yourself. Be yourself, build yourself, and I will see you on the other side.
take his bottle.
Just walk.